Do you frequently wake feeling exhausted despite a full night of sleep? How about cravings? Do you often crave salty, crunchy foods? Do you wake around 3 a.m. every single night? What about bloating? Are you feeling that kind of pooch on your stomach that you can't get rid of despite your best efforts? You might have adrenal fatigue. Hi, I'm Taylor Wessel, nutritionist of Taylor Health. Every week I pop on here to share a tip, tool, or technique that will help you be your healthiest self. Today, we are talking about adrenal fatigue. Although this term is not recognized typically in Western medicine, it's a real condition, and I want to break it down for you today. What is adrenal fatigue? What is one thing to do and one thing not to do to start healing your body? Your adrenal glands are two teeny tiny little glands about the size of a walnut or a grape that sit in your lower back quadrant atop each of your two kidneys. These are teeny tiny, but they have a big job to do in the body. And one of their main tasks is to regulate all of the stress that's incoming. That could be physical stress from a hard workout. It could be mental or emotional stress. It could be somebody cut you off on the road and you're stressed because you have to be somewhere. There are all sorts of different stressors that come into our life. And every single one of those has to go through the adrenal glands. Not sleeping great at night is another example. Chemical stressors, mold in your environment. The list really goes on and on about how taxing stress can be on your body. The adrenals do not just process stress. They also work hand in hand with the kidneys to regulate the fluids in the body and how your body distributes those fluids inside the cells versus outside the cells. The adrenals play a role in digestion and your immune system, inflammation. If your adrenals are overtaxed by stress, you will quite simply not have energy for the day, and you will constantly feel bloated and puffy despite your best efforts. This is an extremely large problem for women, especially with the thyroid-adrenal connection. If you're interested in learning more about that, shoot me a message below, and I'd be happy to create a video on it as well. One of the best things that you can do to start to heal your adrenals is to eat high protein meals every 3 to maybe 4 hours. You might even have to start with every 2 to 3 hours until you get your blood sugar regulated again. What happens is that many people, especially women, try to do intermittent fasting and going too long without eating as a method of trying to cut back on calories and lose weight, and that's actually working against them. What you need to do is eat breakfast, high protein breakfast, within the hour of rising, and then every 2 to 3 hours thereafter, maybe working up to 3 to 4. But that's keeping your blood sugar more stabilized throughout the day. The reason that this is important is because when your blood sugar dips so low because you've gone too long without eating, that's a stressor on the body. And that calls to your adrenals to start releasing sugar into the bloodstream so that you actually have energy. And that's where you get that adrenaline rush. Well, if you're on the blood sugar roller coaster all day by either eating highly refined carbohydrates and sugars, or not eating frequently enough and not getting enough protein in your diet, your adrenals will constantly have to be dealing with this stress, and you quite simply won't have energy and your weight won't be regulated because the adrenals are overworked and overfunctioning and they can't get to their other responsibilities. So eating high protein meals every few hours is the most important thing that you can do for your adrenals. And one of the worst things that you can do, which is along that same line, is fasting. This is not a technique that's good for you at this period of time. I know this might seem like a shocker to the system because intermittent fasting is seen as the mecca for weight loss and hunger and craving control, but In the same way that you want to eat protein more frequently throughout the day, limiting your food intake can actually cause that blood sugar to dip and again, the adrenaline to kick in and to just be taxing your adrenals all day long. What you can do is go 12 hours between dinner and breakfast without eating. Because if you think about it, you should be stopping eating a good 3 hours before bed. And then you sleep for 8 hours. So that's 11 hours right there. And if you eat within the hour of waking, you have your 12 hours. That will allow for complete digestion, a good night of sleep, and to wake up feeling refreshed. Although there is so much more to talk about on the topic of adrenal health and how to balance your adrenals better, I'm going to leave it there for today. I hope that you now understand the many functions of the adrenals and one thing to do to help you start regulating them and one thing to avoid. If you're interested in learning more, drop me a comment and I'd be happy to make more videos on adrenal fatigue, what to do, what not to do. If you liked this, give it a like, share it with somebody who could use the help, and be sure to subscribe to my channel. Every Wednesday and Sunday, I'm coming at you with a new video sharing a tip, tool, or technique that will help you do that little bit better, to feel better, to function better, and show up more fully in this world. I hope you have a great rest of your day. See you next time.